Oh, yeah. Good. Some teams like to milk every little second they have. You guys were milking it yesterday. I want to say milking it.
Well, when your captain is your pink or blue spot, you can just let it ride.
That's true.
That's, I think OG probably did that, so we could blame OG for that 10 seconds right there.
Just let it ride. Well, here we go. They have first pick. They're going to have first ban here.
But the ban Shadow Demon first.
Yep, there it is.
I mean, OG doesn't really feel pressured to change anything, I would say. Like, nope. Their openings were fine.
Yep. And VP is going to ban Naga. It just seems like if you first ban Naga one game, you're going to first ban it the next game, more than likely.
Question is, do they ban the Drow this time around?
So OG has first pick, right?
Yeah.
And VP has second. Maybe they'll leave. I don't know. Yeah, they should probably just ban the Drow.
Well, we're going to see probably a Warlock or a Drow come through. I think those are some of the power picks that are left.
We saw OG ban a Lifestealer last time.
Yeah, that's right.
And there it is again. Yep. Noni, like you said, you just won 11 minutes. Why would you change it up?
So I'd say, like,
this is the interesting one, right? The one coming
up. Yeah, it's like Drow or Warlock, or they make a trade.
Yeah.
We've seen a few teams do that where they just ban a kind of different here, like Ogre or Dirge, and then they take the other one that no one picks, but they leave the Drow. OG's
turn to pick. I think OG takes it with the first pick. Could be wrong, though. They beat EG's Drow yesterday, so they're comfortable playing against the hero as well.
Mm. Yeah.
What else would they pick if it wasn't a Drow?
Might go for Batrider.
I get S4 seems super comfortable, and we saw that last fight. He was super farmed pretty easy.
Yeah. It just suits their style really well.
They take the Drow.
I think that would be Radiant team picking, like, first picking a bat into, like, an Oracle, I think is pretty scary. But if Virtus Pro doesn't pick kind of any anti-bat here, I don't see why OG wouldn't go back for the Batrider with their second pick. And then they can ban out those anti-bat heroes.
I think VP goes Ogre or bat here.
I think definitely take the bat.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't give it to OG now. They just instantly snap it up, maybe.
I don't like this opener because you... Or I don't like the opener for VP in this situation or these bans because then you have... Take the bat, and then they take Ogre, and then does OG just take Oracle? And then I feel like OG's won the first two.
Yeah.
Great call, Sumail.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Now we see, so do you, Oracle's the pick here. If you were drafting, you'd take Oracle.
I think he's really, really... I mean, he's super good against Batrider.
Yeah, and you get the Drow or Harassing lane a lot easier.
I mean, it's just that sustain you need for Drow as well, so that she can actually stand on the front line. And then Oracle's nerfs, which was just attack damage recently.
Well, they're kind of mitigated.
But they go for the Drow Puck opening.
That's what you guys did, right?
We've been doing it. Wings has been doing it. OG's doing it too.
Now we see VP just instantly bans out the Oracle now. OG.
I was wrong. Feels bad.
That's fine. No, everyone's wrong once in a while. I haven't been in a little bit, but it's all good.
Not sure about that pick, though, to be honest.
Well, I think it's more okay now because Bat is in the game. That means there isn't really going to be a chance for Nyx to appear in the game, which is, I think, is Puck's, like, this opening's Radiant biggest weakness is the Nyx assassin, I would think.
I think they could have Void. They could have picked Void, I guess.
OG?
Yeah. Puck draw. I just don't like it.
I think it's okay this game. I mean, Puck versus Bat should be an okay lane. If VP decides to go aggro, which they probably...
I mean, they should go aggro against Drow Ranger.
I really don't see
a point of not doing it.
Yeah.
I think that was the first time we've seen Drow not get aggroed, because even when, like, the Drow lane wins the aggro tri-lane, it's enough disruption. Like, he can't just run at you at 10 minutes in with full farm at middle. Yeah. You lose a 5-0.
If you leave the Drow alone, the support hero can just get off the lane and Drow's solo experience and free farm and treads in a Dragonlance and hit your tier 1 towers before you can do anything.
Yep. OG bans out the sniper. Seen no one play it pretty well. OD gets banned out this time by VP.
Virtus Pro banned the OD this time, so... Learning from last game, not wanting that hero up against Drow, but also not wanting Ana to play that with Drow Aura.
Yep.
What are some anti-Drow heroes that you think VP could pick for their core positions?
I think Dragon Knight can be one of them. He's pretty good against Puck and Drow Ranger.
Yeah.
And were they the team that played? No, it was OG that played Dragon Knight yesterday.
Yeah, was that when he went the hood first and then armlet?
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah,
that was against tanky. Us, too.
I guess I like the build.
Yeah, it was a tiny.
He played Dragon Knight twice.
Yeah, you jumped in. The stun toss combo did, like, 150 damage to him.
Yeah, my hero felt pretty garbage after, like, 10 minutes.
That was okay. So, Sven ban.
Yeah. I think I mean, if we go by the philosophy that you have to fight a tier ones, a core like, what do you say? The hero you call out. Or VP.
What did I say? Me?
Someone said some hero.
I said Dragonite.
Dragonite's very good at that, because you can force fights at their towers, and he's also okay at defending towers.
I think we saw VP play Dragonite.
Yeah.
Yep.
Dragonite. Ah.
All right.
And you guys are just...
Sumail, the man.
Oh, Sumail just calls all over the place, my man.
I mean, it's good, right? Because when you lean in mid and you get the passive...
Yeah, like, draw damage doesn't do much. Yeah. Like, you just sit there and farm. Because you can reduce their damage, too.
But now they picked their middle hero, so OG... I mean, if you're OG, what would you want middle against Dragonite now?
The Lightning Revenant?
Yeah, if they pick Razor, like...
I like Razor.
Sir Davian's gonna be miserable in the mid lane.
That's the
Night Davian, poor guy.
It's kind of a hard part about picking Sir Davian like this early on, is that he's really exposed in the middle lane against a hero like Razor, which can really just ruin his game pretty much. And it doesn't matter if you're tanky against DPS when you have like.
But I wouldn't like Razor, Puck, and Draw Force. They picked Invoker.
Okay.
That's a pick I don't like.
Yeah, I'm not that fun of the Invoker either.
Why?
It just feels... I mean, you look at these three cores of Drow, Puck, and Invoker, and you don't really have a frontliner in any way, and you don't, as of now, have a save against Power Rider.
Yeah.
So you're going to be forcing fights at these tier 1 towers, and it's mainly going to be Drow that's hitting them.
So with that Oracle band, are we looking for some sort of defensive support for Fly?
I would think so.
So maybe like Avenge or an Abaddon or I mean there's not something to save from Lasso, right?
Yeah. I think they really need to save this game. But also if they pick Venge, their lanes aren't that strong, I would think, against something like Bad Ogre. And then you also have Lil Seer, which is unknown at the time. He's played a lot of like Enchantress and stuff, which really can mess up your lanes if you pick these weaker supports that have saves against Lasso.
Bloodseeker.
Bloodseeker. Okay, boys.
Goodness gracious.
What's going on? That's
that Ramsey's hero?
Seems like a quick tool for me.
No, this is a good Bloodseeker game.
Okay, and who's playing it? Who's playing it? Is it the carry? Is it Ramsey's? Or do they do some crazy Lil 4 support Bloodseeker?
Like
when they pick random heroes like Weaver and stuff, like at the end of the lineup, and you're like, oh, okay. It's just Lil. He's just playing it.
Yeah.
And it works. You're like,
Lil
okay.
support Weaver.
Yeah.
I mean, he has played it before. I know that. Lil has played Bloodseeker jungle before. And it's... I think it's an okay game for it. I mean, if you rupture this Drow and then let your eyes run on top of him... he's pretty exposed.
Is that the Fly hero?
It's a defensive support. But it's not a save. Yeah. You know, if Drow gets lassoed and brought into the fight, doesn't matter if you get shallow graved or not. Like, he's still just gonna die after the grave.
I think that's one of my favorite parts. When you see a fourth pick, you don't know if it's gonna be support carry offlane. You see what the other team thinks it is, and then if they're wrong, you know, you just kind of chuckle.
Yeah, that's the cool thing that VP can do here is they can run that Bloodseeker jungle, or they could pick another support and just lane the Bloodseeker. I don't know how much. I mean, their late game is probably okay. There's just a certain timing they have to defend against OGs.
Do you think OG's going to pick Pudge again?
I don't think so. I think that would be like one of your allies gets ruptured and you just try and save him with Hook.
Oh, sorry.
Just dies.
My bad.
No, something that can just stand your ground, I think, is the way you want to do it. So I like Abaddon, but I don't know. Maybe they don't play it.
Doesn't seem like a Jarixer to me.
I'm an Abaddon like fanboy, so.
What about why is Dirge bad here?
Dirge is not bad at all.
Dirge can be fine.
It's not bad at all.
Okay.
Another heal. See, throw that tomb up in front of the tower.
Only problem I see with OG's lineup this game is that it's harder for them to start fights compared to last game. They don't really have this direct initiation. That's the punch. Oh my god.
What? Oh my god, why?
Maybe he's just doing a support quest.
Sometimes
do you think he has the homeless bane set?
Probably.
Chen.
There it is.
So it is a carry Bloodseeker then.
It's a very smart move from VP, I think.
They can win their lanes.
Yeah. Dazzle and Bane are both very, very vulnerable against the Chen. Like, you just try lane safe lane, and then you have this Batrider with some some Chen and some Satyr just in your lane.
Yeah. Do you think that... What do you think, like, that Puck versus Bloodseeker matchup 1v1 is going to be like?
I think it's pretty miserable for a Puck.
Yeah.
With
Drawer?
Yeah, no, even with Drawer, I think.
Yeah, normally I'd say Bloodseeker completely crushes that line, or that lane. But with Drawer, maybe it's a bit different.
I knew that was a matchup, like a mid-matchup before that Bloodseeker just destroyed.
Yeah, you just, like, Puck actually can't do anything. I mean, he has to, like, go all in, like, first wave, I think.
Yeah.
Just, like, try to kill him, actually. That's the only way I see Puck winning this lane. Otherwise, it's going to be like...
And then Ogre could start in any lane he wants. So if Ogre started bottom and kind of zoned out the Puck for a wave, then could have huge problems.
I think an early thing we saw last game, too, I mean, we talked about during game, but not after, is the warding. OG just completely outwarded VP. They lost both their wards middle super early.
Yeah, Jerix crushed it.
Yeah, Jerix. First blood, the double outward.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, you got a first blood like that, and your support Pudge, all of a sudden you can buy a ward and a sentry, and...
He's scouting up here, Jerix. Has boots, has a ward. Lil saw him. Oh, I'm surprised he shows himself before coming to ward. Man, he's just going to go for the kill here. Doesn't look like he can. He has boots. He's going to run away.
He has the Hobus head, doesn't he?
No, that's not it.
It's a different one.
It's like the nightmare.
He's wearing a rope.
Those are like, I don't know, some sort of like wood kind of spikes.
Well, there we go. No ward placed by Jerix. They're running back uphill. Bane trades reasonably well, obviously brain set, but he skills Nightmare first. And there we go, they're coming up. They want to get past him and block him in. They should be able to here. There it is. Orb comes out. He's in a lot of trouble. And I guess since they saw him sticky goo him earlier, they knew, well, if we get a sleep off, he's dead. It's an easy kill for him again. And now they secure top rune for themselves. Bottom rune will go to VP.
They saw both wards, so.
Yeah.
I think Chen has sentries in his inventory, he's just waiting. Yeah.
Doesn't want to get slapped.
At least they will get a counter ward. We see Puck trying to harass bottom a little bit, but DS4, 8 tangos. Ready for some harass.
This guy's going to be a lot different.
Oh, no, he's sentry too.
Oh.
They double blocked that camp, so.
Yeah, he's not getting that.
That's tough. We saw just earlier MPSVG really depended on that offlane camp.
Yeah, what he wants to do is just take that Chen creep and head towards the top lane, make sure Batrider can lane up there.
Yep, anything's really good.
I don't think they can aggro, though. Like, in that OG trial lane.
I don't think
it's pretty
so.
Hard. Yeah.
I feel like those, like, Bane and Dazzle could just right-click the Chen creep, almost.
They probably need Ogre to do it.
Even Ogre. Like, even if he comes in, like, I don't think they can do anything.
I think they can do it with Ogre. They just smoke up there with Ogre or Chen creep and Chen. And then they just like right click this Dazzle.
Bane's actually going bottom though, so
yeah.
Bat Raider's kind of 1v1ing up here against Drow, which is good for him.
We see Dazzle moving over the lane now.
What?
Bottom lane? I mean, it just looks like pretty normal lanes at this point. We see Dazzle trying to harass him top. Ramsey's just farming up. It's a Quelling Blade.
Yeah. Maybe Bane and Puck can though. Keep this Pulse Group for the first couple of levels.
Just have some Force Blue to play in the lane so he can't pull. And they are. They're just going right onto him. Not really too much kill potential.
It's a risky Blood Rage. I think the play there is that if you want to get the heal off a creep like that, you're just Blood Rage the creep instead. So you don't take like 5 auto attacks with the buff.
Ah, the pull on the side.
And OG gets the pull on the side. It's a good pull. Little moving over. Didn't use the smoke. He's going for the chicken here. Uh-oh. It's the Bassy.
It's the Bassy.
Do they have the ward? Oh. Looked like he was right online to get that, too. But he's just going to jungle the big camp instead. S4. Just going to be harassing this Ogre. Ramsey's doing a good job lasting all the creeps.
He's getting a lot out of this lane.
Yeah.
I guess Puck is, too, though. I mean, you have to look at the exchange here. It's that if Bane wasn't here, Puck would get pretty much nothing.
Yeah, I don't love the laning phase here for VP.
Oh, here we go. Ramsey's going to get woken up. We're going to see the orb flying. Only level 1. Stun comes out on the Bane. Phase shifts off the damage. And they're just going to right click. So how good is Rupture this game? It's not that good, right? I mean, they have the Bane, the Dazzle, like the double heal, the sleep. Like, yeah. You Rupture him, and it's kind of scary to fight.
It's all about if OG or if VP can force them to run.
If they have numbers. The numbers can force them to run.
If OG's able to stand and fight, then... Rupture will do nothing.
Yep. Which happens in a lot of games, it feels like.
I mean, I think on paper, Rupture is a really good spell against this Drow Ranger.
Yeah, it really is.
Any hero that just wants to sit and auto-attack you, but isn't really, like, any glass cannon hero, pretty much. It's just very vulnerable to this Rupture spell.
Dragonite's crushing this lane.
17-4 versus 10-1.
Is this just the player skill? Or is it something
Excuse
else?
Me.
Bless you.
Is this the player skill? Or is it...
I mean, this matchup favors Dragonite for, like, the first four waves, I would say.
But... Yeah. The force
Uh-oh, bottom lane, Jarex gets off the brain steps, has a sleep. Sleeps on him. Oh, solo. Oh, my. Batrider actually kills the Drow Ranger. Bloodseeker kills Bane.
Oh, Chen rotated top.
Here we go. Dead as well.
He's still looking.
No, I think he's dead.
He's gonna get run that.
Oh.
I think that was a really bad phase shift.
Yeah, he should have phase shifted over the tower, right?
He's got another phase shift.
There it is. Oh, but the Blood Rage wears off. He still gets it, but he's in a lot of trouble now. He might just die to that.
Oh,
and Jarex gets the experience from it.
Worth or not worth?
Not worth.
Not worth.
Because Bane gets level 4.
Bane's level 4. Oh, my. Denied. But a good kill top. No-tail actually goes down. It seems like Batrider's good at that. So 1v2 lane. You
I
get
think,
a little cocky.
Yeah, I think Chen was there with the creep though.
But when you're in the game, like, you just want to go for it, you know.
Oh, here
really
we go. We have the triple stun. Triple stun golem. There's one, there's two, three, one more. There it is. Kill for the Chen.
The drive by.
Drive by. Three little golems.
Just goofy little golems.
It's adorable.
Yeah. They really are, dude.
Sumile kind of looks like you a little.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I kind of like. I kind of don't like the fact that Chen didn't go. Go for Q though.
Oh, bottom lane, Ramzes. Here comes solo on that ogre. Just get it right, Clay Q. He loves doing that.
I think Chen
plays ogre every game.
He really does. One disruptor, game six ogres or something.
It's a rough life, man.
At least you're needed. Here comes chicken flying in. Nothing's happening. Solo just get harassed out of lane.
It's pretty chill.
They're actually just going for him though. They need to dive again. Uh-oh, the TP's coming in from pink, and this is might have been overcommitment. Sunstrike comes out. Gets split three ways though. Poison comes out. One more attack.
It's 8 sticks.
Needs one more. He has 8 stick charges.
Just 5 more attacks.
Has a raindrop.
Running.
Ogre died to newts.
No, Ogre died to newts. So they commit pink bottom. At least no one dies, but they don't get anyone as well. Uh-oh, middle lane again. He's just gonna harass him.
Drive by again. Chen's on his way.
Oh, he's coming behind, maybe. Oh, top lane. No-tail's in a little trouble. He knows everyone TP'd. This is just looking like almost a free kill.
It's true. Yeah, they saw the TP's bottom. Yeah. He just went for it. He knew no one could react.
That was super smart.
Yeah, Drow's having a rough laning phase now.
I mean, there's a problem with Invoker, right? They saw the dragon, and then they picked this Invoker. He doesn't
Uh-oh.
Really win his lane.
Lil's just here. He graves him up, though. Oh, but the stun comes out, and he's most likely to die. I think we have one heal left. There it is. But Chen picks it off.
Lil is like the king of last hitting. He always gets it.
Now Drow's just middle.
It's just such a good game for this Chen hero. He's really able to run around and do pretty much anything he wants.
Yeah,
because they have those double, just really defensive supports. Or
yeah, and they're two heroes that can't really do anything to a Chen creep. So. Smart pick.
They also have really good heroes to complement him. I mean, this Batrider and Dragonite. As soon as Dragonite hits 6, and as soon as Bat's like level 2 or whatever, they have a lot of kill potential. Like, just one Chen creep comes into the lane.
Now we see. Oh, just to sleep. Here comes Sunstrike. It is going to be split two ways again onto that creep, so it absorbs a little damage. They're going to try to chase him down, though. Stun comes out. He's going to be able to just fly away, has some stick charges. That's 4 still going for it. He's just in. He's in. And now he's out.
Out of there.
If he angles that Sunstrike properly,
yeah, it would have been full.
Right? Astro could have salvaged in a way. Like, he just, like, used both his spells and killed the archer. And then there's, like, no spit. Sunstrike. They could have played it way better than they did. But that's Dota right there.
And now they lose the puck. He commits fully. He knew he wasn't getting out.
Still a pretty hard kill. I mean, they have to sleep, and then they have to wait for Sunstrike, and then puck spells have to land, and it's like
I don't think so, because he was, like, blood raged. That was a pretty free kill, I would say.
Uh-oh, and there we go. We see the first Rupture. He's just running. He's running to the tower. He's going to sleep himself, possibly. Yes, he does. Ramzes will wake him up. They both get woken up. Heal comes out. They kill him. Ramzes trying to run away. Will there be enough? The orb. He dodges it. That speed, and Ramzes, is he going to get away again? He's just out. He is. Level 1 poison flies trying to kill solo, but there's a lot of creeps on you, buddy.
Beat is my game.
S4 going for that Bloodseeker kill is going to help. It's going to allow solo to escape. It's life.
Yep. And there's a... No-tail just trying to farm middle now. Dragon Knight is... What level is Dragon Knight? 7? Oh boy. Level 8 now after a creep. He's having a great time.
What do we guess this series? 2-1?
And there we go. They're just going in middle. Lasso comes out. One sticky on him. It doesn't matter. He's just dropping. When you don't have a Dazzle TPing to save you, feels bad.
Top four net worths. VP.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's not good for a Drow lineup.
I mean, this is just a really good example of how you should deal with a Drow. In contrast to the last game.
So I mean, yeah, why didn't they do this game one?
Well,
they didn't even try Lin though, right? It was just Batrider, just 2v1. They just had the Chen really helping.
They have totally different heroes this game than the last game.
I mean, last game they had a Centaur against Dry Rubik, and that hero does not pose a threat at all in the lane. This game they have Bat with the Chen.
Oh, and here we go. Rupture comes out again. He's gonna coil both of them. Jarek's here sleeping the Bloodseeker. We're gonna see a Sunstrike comes out, fully hits him. Ogre goes down now, and here we go. No Tail, level 2 Frost Arrows should slow him down enough. Sticks up. He's gonna survive. Now they're chasing a Bat, and they just can't bring down this Bloodseeker.
If anything, I think VP should stop going to their safe lane, because there's no way you're gonna kill a hero with the Rupture and an Ogre like that in the lane, I think, especially with the Dazzle in the game.
Yeah, it's way too close to the tower for something like that.
But and
short cooldown spell.
Well, OG has this thing where a lot of the times when they're behind, they're just gonna run into your safe lane.
Dire scans it. They might go for a Sunstrike here. Assume that's what it's for. Or oh no, he's just gonna brain zap him. Okay, sick.
Level 6.
That's Zumbar.
526 gold.
That was interesting why he played that so greedy, because, I mean, we saw the Batrider sticky Napalm. They were clearly still in the jungle. Just got greedy because they're winning.
Yeah. Just got greedy. That's what carry players do.
This needed to happen a lot earlier, that they secured this tower, because OG has not been up here for a while. Like, we saw Drago to mid lane, because he actually can't stay in this lane.
Yep, now we see No Tail takes bottom tower, but Chen takes top, and it looks like he's going for that super. He's skipping the mech, I believe, to go for the Ags. We see that sometimes.
I don't like that. I don't like that at all.
Why?
Someone else getting mech?
VP just does. Uh-oh. And they a little early on the orb. They're going to miss, but Sunstrike comes out, get a hit onto him. Should be able to bring him down. Oh, he's gripped. No. He's gripped him over the hill. Okay.
So Chen Ags is good against teams that have lots of like magical AoE damage, because you can get the Ancients, which are magic immune. It allows you to split push, but you're playing up against a Drow lineup that has tons of physical right click damage. They're going to be able to just kill those Ancients. Having like a mech and a Vlad's and more armor for your team is definitely the way to go.
You see OG grouping up. They have the Drow, they have the damage. Are they going to try to fight at this tier 1? We see Orange behind them, so most likely they are. Sleep comes out onto the Ogre. We hear DK stunning somewhere from the top side. And here comes the Chen creeps. Rupture comes out, I believe.
It's
yep.
On the invoker.
It's on the invoker. Trying to run away. Anna's just got to stand still, but he gets stunned out by the Centaur. He's getting grave. Sunstrike comes out on the backside. Only really going to hit the Ogre, it looks like. He's dead. Are they going to get anyone else? S4 trying to run away. Bottle charges up a little bit. Flame break pushes them actually a little bit forward. He has another stun on no one. Who's going to go for? Nice silence. It actually holds him back because of that.
They are chasing through the door.
And now they're turning around. Uh-oh, and now they're going back in again. He base shifts, he gets slept up. This time Sader goes in. Oh, pushes him back into that. Now No Tail gonna go down. Ramzes, right clicking.
Buck buyback, he's got coil.
He does, and there it is, the coil. Should be able to bring down Ramzes, tries to send back, doesn't. And now he could be in a little bit of trouble. Sunstrike comes out, he just TPing though, misses anyways. Fly, should go down the heel. Pasha.
Yeah. Losing a lot of heroes on OG here.
We are. Yikes. He's gonna try to get away, and Dragon Form runs out, so he will. Okay. Was that just the puck buyback?
Yeah, they lost 5 there.
Yeah.
To VP's 2, I believe.
Yikes. We saw them, they were overcommitting with that weave on him, then they just ran back, weave wore off, and they just went back in again.
Yeah, it was a very good buyback from Puck, but they're just too far behind at this point to get the kills they needed off that buyback.
I mean, Sir David is pretty strong at this point.
He's very strong at this point. I mean, he's level 11. He has an armor at 12 minutes. He's going to get blood raged. And it's very difficult for you to deal with him right now.
Yeah, even with that blood rage like bonus Radiant damage that he takes, OG still doesn't have enough to deal with him, so he's just dealing so much damage in fights.
Actually, they're immune blood rage and blood loss.
Oh, yeah, that too.
I guess they have blood rage too.
They're both
but
good.
But the blood loss just completely, it's really hard to get kited when you have an ogre on your team.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know, I said he was hasted, maybe
Rupture
he was bloodlusted.
Sorry, yeah, Rupture comes out in 7-4, S4 again.
Doesn't have a port.
Uh-oh, see he gets silenced before, no, he gets out, but the Rupture damage he's gonna get, great. I think he's dead. It's not looking good for him right now.
I think Buck's game is over, man.
Puck's not having fun. Bad. 4-4-2.
If you're Puck in this situation, are you typing end in all chat?
No, I'm just typing end like team chat, I guess.
All right.
Not moving to that. Uh-oh, and Anna actually gets found now. Asha sitting back. Will he get the silence off? That doesn't stop TPs anymore, my good man. He'll live.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh, a grip down bottom, but here comes the Centaurs. They're here. Gets one stomp off. Slep could wake himself up. Doesn't even have to.
Oh, the body.
They're trying to body block. Try. The cart's chasing him even.
The cart.
Two Centaurs, a cart, and a Satyr. They just run away, so a Bane ult kind of wasted. Puck goes down as well. But at least Invoker does survive.
Is he going to Blink here on DK? Or
I think just go Maelstrom or something.
He went.
Actually, Blink is pretty good this game.
Yeah, in the last game we saw him play, I think he went Blink.
Yeah, I'd say Blink is pretty good. Just get on top of this.
Maybe you can get Shadow Blade, I guess. Just so you have more damage and stuff. And you're like skill better late game.
Yeah, usually those are your two options.
I think I'd prefer Blink in this case. Just having like some secondary form of initiation, except this bat rather.
Well, bottom lane, he just gets double stunned. Little's here now, just nukes him up. He's trying to brain sap, does, gets it on a creep though. That cart's still just wheeling around over there.
That car was there.
Been a little more damage. Bloodlusted even. Well, Invoker, a little slower Midas timing than last game.
A little.
By about half, yeah. Just a little. Top lane is going to go for. Maybe look for a kill here, or if not, just go for that tier 2, they could. That's 4 TP's out.
Like OG's grouping up as well, though.
Dragon Knight's at 7.2k net worth.
It's pretty high.
Yeah, it's quite high.
I wonder if they're stacking Ancients for him. Like, if he gets Ancients.
They're Ancients right now. I don't know. I'm not sure if they're stacked, though, on Radiant side.
That's Steel.
Oh, Bloodseeker goes for the Midas. Why do you go for a Midas here? This late, when he's. They're winning.
It's just not a hero that farms particularly fast.
True.
Same timing as Invoker, right?
What?
Same timing as Invoker. The minus nine.
Ooh, that's four.
Uh-oh. Oh, man. Quite a few of them, too. If he gets all three of these, oh. That's 200 gold swing. I'll take anything they can get right now.
I wonder if the Cardi survived.
I believe so.
Cart's alive.
Cart's alive. He's chilling, yeah.
Chilling,
he's not going down anytime soon.
It's on Roche duty.
He's not going to sacrifice him. Well, they're looking for the puck right now. They know he's down here. They see the creeps are pulled. He's
the blink.
S4. Oh, and he just gets found. Will he be able to get it? Can't really break. Oh, and he pulls him back. They don't even have to break it. Should be an easy kill on S4.
Get a rupture off from Bane or something.
See, so he's trying.
Quite yet.
It's nighttime.
I get him.
They know he's there. Pasha's chasing in. TP.
Nope.
Oh, and there is the blink from no one like we talked about. Well, see you later, Jerks. He goes for a suicide. Can't get it. And that is a 2-for-0 trade. Both these games seem to be decided almost by the laning phase. I know it's not over yet, but
it looks
pretty rough.
It's
pretty over.
It's just the way that you're forced to play against this Star Hero. It just makes the games very momentum heavy.
Yeah.
Or momentum based. So in this game, for example, Dra got completely shut down in the early game, and she really hasn't been able to do anything. Well, the first game she was completely free to do whatever she wanted.
I mean, think about Draw here, it's like both teams are under pressure or something. It's not like you have Draw and you're like relaxed or something.
No.
You're under pressure too. Like you have to do stuff or you're gonna lose the game. Especially with this lineup, they have like Buck, Draw, Ranger, Dazzle, Bane. I don't know what do they do late game.
Not a lot. I mean, BP's gonna hit BKB timings on both DK and Bloodseeker at one point. And then
he's running you.
We'll just have a lot of trouble there.
Let me see. Sir Davian is indeed 2,500 up on the net worth chart. Does he just go straight BKB next, or do you think he goes damage?
I hope he buys Maelstrom, sir.
Maelstrom?
Yeah. I mean, if he buys BKB, like that's the only three items he's gonna have all game, yes. I guess. Maybe they're winning. Maybe he gets one more. But if you're like Maelstrom, you can be actually like six slotted by 40 minutes, and then your hero's pretty strong.
Yeah, Dragon Knight's a hero that you know has this like early game kind of pushing stigma behind him, but if he gets if he slots up and has a bunch of items, he's super strong in the late game. His stun is just so big.
Stun is very good.
Yeah, he's like everything, right? He can stun, he has armor, he has splash damage.
He's a threat.
It's very good against heroes like Draw as well. You just blink right on top of him and then it's really hard to
Well, looks like he's going for the Black King bar here.
Black King. I think it's good.
Echo Saber.
I mean,
Echo Saber.
Dragonlance.
Dragon. That could be. Who knows? I doubt it.
Probably BKB.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing is, they can end the game with BKB, so don't think it's that big of a deal,
Let's
I guess.
Go for
it's
true.
Win one fight. You're also ignoring the fact that he has both Bloodlust and Blood Rage, which is like.
Double Blood.
Double Blood.
Sick.
Yeah. That's a lot of damage right here, like DK.
Yeah, it is.
Who doesn't really care about the damage amp from Bloodseekers too, especially if it's BKB.
That's the crazy thing about Ogre. You can pick whatever you want and you'll still farm like at a decent speed with Bloodlust.
Is he going stats here?
Is he?
I hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, how many stats does he want? It's oh, he's going stats.
He did stats again, so two of them, yeah. Just that's the hero, get level 7, you're max.
This guy just understands this hero, man. Like,
it's time for you to make a change to this hero again.
No.
Give him some armor.
This is something I admire. Like, you play this Ogre hero, and you know what to do. You know your hero's not supposed to, like, get Ags and stun people. You're not supposed to, you know, get any items to be impressed with your team, but you're just gonna blow those up. That's what you do.
Yeah.
It's just a really real fun hero.
And that's when a hero starts skilling stats over his other abilities, that's when he needs to change.
That's just what he knows what to do.
That's when he needs more armor.
Yeah, I feel one more armor can hurt him.
I don't know about that one, man. If, like, Ogre has a Greaves and Axe, he's pretty scary. He's like a core. He's basically like a core. He does so much damage.
That's like the Ogre player that wants to be something else than an Ogre.
Yeah. So Sumail, if he played support.
Yeah, so Sumail would have Midas. Maybe.
Yeah, I would have Midas.
Definitely an Iron Talon somewhere in there.
I mean, you already kind of got to go like 4-4-1, but that's not Ogre. Ogre's 1-1-4.
No, it's 1-4-1, dude.
That's the Sumail Venno, right? 4-4-1?
Yeah, that's my Venno right there. Actually never got to play that Venno hero.
Yeah. Well, middle lane, they're just pushing. They have a lot of Ancients now. And a Wolf. Cart seems to be gone, but that's life.
I'm asking a little about this Axe pickup. I'm conflicted.
As
a Chen
said,
player myself, I just...
They said if you're really far ahead, They said in Dream League he did it every time. If they're a little behind, he gets mech.
Yeah,
if not,
I think this is the way he prefers to play Chen, though. He's very... heavy on split push with this hero. I mean, if you look at the map 2 minutes ago or something, they would have 4 heroes on one side of the map, and then Chen would be on the opposite side with all his creeps.
Now he can just do it with the dragon. I think we saw him do it day one.
Oh, it's the Blood Rage Dragon. They have 2 blood buffs for all the dragons as well.
Goodness. It's a bloodbath.
Look at that.
That looks pretty dope, actually. Looks better than the dragon at himself.
Yeah, but well...
That's not,
I don't know, he just looks pretty stupid.
No, with the Blood Rage thing.
The Blood Rage, I thought you meant his face. His face's pretty stupid.
I see, it's pretty bad.
They didn't quite.
So they got their BKB up on DK. Maxed out stun as well. Bloodseekers doesn't really have his yet, but they still have an okay timing here to take whatever they want.
And they're going to take Roche.
Yeah. They're not really.
They don't take it the quickest, though.
No, they do it pretty fast with Blood Rage and Roche.
Yeah. They have Penitence as well.
Here comes all the Craves. We just see Pasha sitting on the outside, ready to pick up anyone who's here, and they're coming over.
They have Bloodlust and Frenzy from the Thunder Tide.
Well, here we go. There might be a fight, man. They're going all the way around, though. They might take this before it happens.
If they're too late.
They're looking for Ramzes. They don't even know this is happening because they see Ramzes. Uh-oh. Roshan goes down. They know everyone's still here. They drum in, actually. Here we go. Oh, S4's going to have to run out of the way. They pull back in the Invoker. DK's going on the Drow. He's BKB. Should wait until attack. Does. Oh, that's Fly, actually, not Drow. Drow's on the backside. Now they're gripping the DK, yeah. This is just a crazy team fight. Heal comes out from VP. Puck drops. No Tail is running the wrong way. Might get called here. OG seems like a fighting team, though. One uphill.
Yeah, I think this is when you call it.
That's something that I've seen with the new VP. I remember old VP never, like, GG'd until, like, he took their throne. New VP just, like, we saw last game, they just left.
It's a good game, 11 minutes. But looks like, I mean, OG, they got that Invoker. Maybe they want to try one uphill fight, Ice Wall Meteor. Not going to do too much, but could.
I mean, this hero is basically useless unless he's, like, 6-slotted.
Invoker?
Yeah, this is pretty much Invoker summed up in one sentence.
So Invoker's useless unless he's 6-slotted?
Yeah, that's Invoker right there.
Invoker, all right. And then he's one of the best in the game, right? Just from last.
I mean, he's the best in the game once he's 6-slotted.
Yeah. Man, what a hero. Jerex.
That's pretty hard to get there, though.
Yeah. So is the idea behind the second pick Puck that Puck is good against Batrider? Or what?
I don't even know if Puck's good against Batrider.
It's just like...
Puck is quite solid with this draw aura.
I get that, but I think you need another. There's a lot of range heroes that are solid.
Jarex, four staffs away, but he's... Oh, he just... BKBs, he's just going for it. It's an interesting 10-second BKB, though.
That was worth it.
That was worth it.
Either kill him or you don't there, so.
It's a mortal victory.
All right. Take it. 20-7 now. They're looking pretty good. Big 180 from the first game.
I would say that Drow Puck is... It's okay, but I think DP definitely exploited some of the weaknesses in the opening, because Puck is not strong enough to be in the offlane by himself, even with Drow Aura.
Yeah,
and this Bloodseeker pick kind of like negated his capabilities to solo that offlane, so they had to move the Bane down there. But by moving Bane down there, they're kind of losing both mid and their safe lane.
True,
and. Picking up both Bane and Dazzle. Two supports we haven't really seen.
Yeah, Puck was kind of a burden on their laning phase, right?
Yeah.
They had to help him, or else.
Or else he gets nothing.
Exactly.
Here we go. We got a Maelstrom on Drow, an Ags on the Invoker. They know they're just running straight to the base. This is the last chance they have here. They're sieging down this tower easily. Glyph comes out, buys some time. Ancient Dunderhide. Give him the Frenzy.
Yeah. He just don't care, man.
He really doesn't. Look at all those buffs. Frenzy, Bloodlust, Bloodbath, Blood everything. They're just killing the tower. Can't do anything.
They have a dragon as well, right? Are they missing one?
They had one. They might be split pushing somewhere. There we go. They blink in. Uh-oh, this Puck does get great. We're going to pull in. Gets him silence as well. That's a quick kill on the Bane. Oh my, Puck goes down as well. They're just chasing him into the base.
All right, this last stand effort isn't going so well.
It's going rough.
This Drow here is just so sad when he gets Drow. He can do nothing.
Dude, no one's just solo killing him with everything in the back line, too. Chen steals that kill.
So you said it's going to be 2-1 for VP, Peter?
Yeah, I'm thinking either 2-1 for VP or OG at this point.
All right, but going back to it, Zai, we'll talk about it after the break. You can have the break to decide who you want to pick, since you were the only one who actually said 1-1.
Yeah.
So I appreciate that, you know, sticking to true to your word.
I just really like what you did this game. I mean, they went into the first game. Maybe they didn't know that OG was going to go for a draw right away. Maybe they just had to lose that one game to draw to realize that OG values this hero like the most out of all the options, and I think they adapted.
They've got OG right where they want them.